In this video, we are going to download and install VSFTPD, which is a FTP daemon in our Kali Linux virtual machine. So I have with me here Kali Linux virtual machine in VMware workstation. First and foremost, we need to ensure that the network is set up properly. Okay, so go to your virtual machine settings here and make sure that for the network adapter, it is actually chosen to be NAT. So this will allow your virtual machine to go through your host machine's network adapter to reach the internet, right? So and ensure that it is connected at the moment so that you can reach the internet. Next, we're gonna log into our machine, okay? And we are going to install the FTP daemon. And the way we do that is, we will open up a terminal window, and we're going to do sudo apt-get install vsftpd, and give it the password for the user Kali, and done. Oh, and it says unable to locate the package vsftpd. What you need to do before that is actually to do a sudo apt-get update, alright, to update the packages available, and we'll give it a while for completion, and let's run the command again. Alright, so you can see that now it succeeds. Right, and VS FTPD is installed. Okay. And now that I have downloaded VS FTPD and installed, what we next need to do is to start the VS FTPD services. Okay, so the FTP service can be started using the system control command, and to do this, let's do sudo system control start vsftpd. Right, there's no error, so let's just check the status. Okay, and let's give it status vsftpd, and you can see it is active and is running currently, the vsftpd service, right? Okay, now that we have installed the FTP server, we will install the FTP client, right? You need the client to talk to the server. How to do that? Basically, again, using the sudo command, sudo, we are going to do an apt-get install FTP, right? And there you go. And it's already installed on this system. Yeah, so we are good here. Okay, and we will proceed on to test the FTP server. Now, to actually test the FTP server, let's create a user on this system. Right, so let's do a sudo user add, okay, -m -s to give it a shell of bash. Right, let's call it FTP user. Okay, and again, basically this is to say that we are going to add a FTP user called, we're going to add a new user called FTP user on this system. Right, and we're going to give it a shell of bin bash. Okay, and so if you do not understand what all these options mean, the way to check is basically to do a user add, right? --- help. Okay, and you're going to see the different options, right? So -m again is to create the home directory. --s is to assign it the login shell. Okay, so this user that we have created, the FTP user, okay, basically currently does not have a password set yet. Okay, so what we're going to do is we are going to give it a password. Okay, to do that, basically we will do a sudo password. sudo password FTP user. Okay, so we're prompted for the new password. Let's give it a super secure password of 007. Okay, so it is the super secure password that is set for this FTP user, right? And it's just the characters 007. Okay. Okay, so now that we have created our user and given it a secure password, or not so secure password, now let's proceed to test our FTP server. So to do that, key in the command FTP and followed by 127.0.0.1. Okay, we are going to use the loopback address to test the FTP server. And you can see it's connected to the FTP server, the VS FTP server plus the version, right? And it's prompting you for a username, right? So key in the username that we have created, FTP user, and the password. And as you can see, we are logged in to the server via FTP, and we can do things like directory listing, right? We can do the usual FTP commands, right? And to get out of the FTP client, just type quit. And we're back into our shell.